Well, this creek is like a miniature Big Darby Creek. Okay, everything you see in here came from Big Darby Creek, even the water. So Big Darby Creek has over 100 different species of fish. And we have a representation in here, probably maybe about 20. And there's also 44 species of mussels that live in Big Darby Creek too. And they are nature's filter feeders and natural filters. And they cannot live in polluted water, but at the same time, they make clean water even cleaner. So Big Darby Creek is a very diverse creek, and it's due to all the diversity that live in and around it. Now, Big Darby Creek, the bottom of the creek is really rocky, just like what you see here, but the mussels, they prefer a more sandier substrate so they can actually get a hold and dig themselves in, so to speak. They have a foot that they use, which is an appendage that comes out so they can move through that substrate. So they need that soft substrate in order to move. We also have in here a large bullfrog. We have turtles. We have four turtles in here. Painted turtle. We also have two map turtles in here, and also one eastern spiny softshell turtle. He's flat like a pancake, and he usually stays pretty hidden, but in the last few days he's been very active. And that's a long-nosed gar. They don't chew their food, so when he catches a fish, they're usually sideways. So you can see some of the other fish that we have in here. We have bluegills, we have rock bass. And it's really clear how you can see it right now, and that's how it looks in the creek too. You can see the bottom of the creek when you stand in the Big Darby and Little Darby as well. It's like we have little dams that create little moving water to help, you know, give this a real creek feel. What we do water changes where you do have to, since this doesn't go anywhere, it just recirculates, we do have to take water out and replenish it. And we do get loss from evaporation as well. But we do try to take the water out just to keep it fresh. This is why we have the little creek and the stream and the nature center as a point of focus, so we can educate the people the importance of keeping the Big and Little Darby Creeks as pristine as we possibly can. Because, I mean, we want them to, when these children grow up and have children of their own, we want the creek to be just like it is right now.